Welcome to our channel, my dear students. Today we are going to talk about the very important topic, that is the previous year, that is last 10 years CBSE board chemistry questions in part 35, in which we are going to discuss aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acid chapter. So here the question number one is, arrange the following in increasing order of acid strength. If you want to look out the acid strength, we have to keep it in mind. So how many number of electron donating group is there and electron withdrawing group is there. Otherwise, you can see about in terms of a plus I and minus I effect. So here I have electron donating groups. Here all electron donating groups. So the H plus will not move as it is very easily. But in this case, if you compare, so near it has electron donating group, but here it picks the electrons, it pulls the electrons of this. So this will be very near to this COOH functional group. That's what the H plus will leave fast. But in this case, also we have one electron donating group, but withdrawing group is also be there. But the distance between this acid is very long when compared to this one. That is what more acidic, if you compare this, more acidic in nature, and this was less acidic in nature, and this is what the least acidic in nature. Okay, so based on that electron plus I effect and minus I effect, we can say which one is more acidic and which one is less acidic, we can predict with that plus I and minus I effect. How do you convert the benzoic acid to benzamide? Benzoic acid to benzamide. So as we know that the benzoic acid, the structure of benzoic acid is like that. Okay. So I'm having benzoic acid, that is the C double bond O, OH is there. If it is react with ammonia, suppose if I'm taking NH2 here H, so it will be eliminated as water molecule. Will be eliminated as water molecule. You just compare it. So I'll be getting the product like this. That is benzoic acid to benzamide. I'll be getting a product. It's a trick to find out the benzoic acid to benzamide as a product. It is a just trick, just eliminate water molecule. By the way, it's not a mechanism. It's just a trick to find the products. It's a benzamide. And next one is give the test to distinguish benzoic acid and benzaldehyde. So this is also very very simple test. As we know that if you use sodium bicarbonate NaHCO3, so if you use this here, it gives brisk effervescence. So here there is no brisk effervescence. By that way, we can able to find out it's a benzoic acid or not. If you use sodium bicarbonate, that time I'll be getting brisk effervescence. There is nothing but carbon dioxide is getting eliminated. But in this case, the benzaldehyde will not involve reaction with sodium. Here the question number 4 is, which one is more acidic? This question was asked in the year of 2013. So here the fluorine and chloride is there. Fluoride and chloride is there. CH2COOH is there. Then compared to this fluoride and chloride, the fluoride are having high electron negative. That's what it can push the electron very easily. So H plus wants to move, leave very easily. That's what it is more acidic in nature. But in the case of a phenol and acetic acid, you can look at. So here one electron withdrawing group is there. But after if it removal of this H plus, the phenoxyanion is getting stabilized. Resonance stabilization is there. But here the carboxylic acid, it is a good carboxylic acid. When compared to this pKa value, it will be very, very, very high for this. And here CH3CO, C double bond O group is there. That C double bond O is nothing but electron withdrawing group. That can pulse the electrons of hydrogen. So the H plus wants to leave once. From this acetic acid is very easily, so that it is a highly acidic in nature when compared to phenol. The next question is, electrophilic substitution reaction benzoic acid takes place at meta position Y. That's a question. So here we have to identify meta position will be high electron density. Then only the electrophile, normally electrophile will have a positive charge. The electrophile will come and attack very easily at the negative end, where the negative charge is there, that place the electrophile will go and attack. According to that rule, here the CO bond will cleaves and which will moves. Because of that, this bond will break and gives electrons. So if it breaks, if this bond is getting break, it got negative charge, got positive charge. So we want to neutralize this. This bond is getting break, this got positive charge, and neutralize this, I will be getting formed a double bond. Once a double bond is getting formed, again this positive charge is to be neutralized. That's what this bond will break, that gives negative charge, and this time positive charge here. And suppose if I got a positive charge, if we want to neutralize this positive charge, so I need to break this bond. So the bond is getting break, it gives its negative charge, it attains positive charge here. Okay, once I got a positive charge here, this double bond is getting break, and this is having a negative charge, this negative charge will goes off, this positive charge will, which will give it positive charge, it will give its positive charge, and negative charge will be there, and these positive will form, negative will form a double bond, and these positive negative will form a double bond. That is what this positive, this bond is getting break, it gives its negative charge, and here this gives its positive charge to this and negative charge to this, and already it's having negative charge here. This negative and positive will form a bond, and here also this positive charge is there already, because it donates electron. That's what it gives negative charge, and it attains positive charge. So this positive charge and this bond is getting break, and this gives negative charge. So these positive and negative will form a double bond. That is what I got, double bond formation. And this positive and negative charge will also be formed, that also form a double bond formation. If you look at this resonance structure, you just listen, this is the ortho position, this is a para position, this is the ortho position to this functional group. Okay, so for this functional group, this is a 1, 2 or 1, 6 is a ortho, 1, 4 is a para. Ortho and para positions are highly electron, not to be electron deficient. Electron deficient, okay. But here, this meta position will have negative charge. If it is a negative charge, the electrophile will come and attack. Electrophile is a positive in nature, so electrophile will come and attack very easily. By that way, it can form a respective products at meta position. And next one is give the order of acid strength. So here, benzoic acid, 3,4 dimetrobenzoic acid, 4 methoxy benzoic acid. We have to write the structure. So benzoic acid I will be writing. This is the structure of benzoic acid. COOH. That's a benzoic acid. 3,4 dinitrobenzoic acid. So 3,4 dinitrobenzoic acid. So I will be writing COOH. And 3,4. 1, 2, 3. So this is 1. This is 1. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3. Third position, am I right? No. This is 1, 2, 3. So this is NO2, 3,4, and fourth position also I have to write NO2, 3,4 dinitrobenzoic acid, and 4 methoxy benzoic acid. So I have to write COOH, and methoxy group is nothing but OCH3 group is there. Okay. So and which one is having more acidic in nature? So if it is electronegative group is there, that time it will be acting as a strong acid. Okay, so if it is electron withdrawing group, in the sense nitro group is a highly electron withdrawing group, and so that moreover benzoic acid is there. In all the case, benzoic acid is common. Only thing is, here there is no substituent, here two substituent, and that substituent is electron negative, so not to be electron withdrawing, and here the substituent is electron donating, so that which will be having more acidic in nature. Okay, and this will be having second one, and this will be having third one. Why? Because one electron donating group is there. That's what the acidic strength will be very less in that case. And the next one is identify ABC as a products. So as we know that here two COOH group is there, that two NH3 which is going to react. So I'll be getting a product like this. I can write the product here. So here the product may be like this. That is C double bond O, ONH4, and C double bond O, ONH4. If I heat this, if I slightly heat this, here there will be elimination of water molecule. So here I'll be getting a product like this, C double bond O, NH2. So here C double bond O, NH2. So I'll be getting diamide. So once I got a diamide, we have to heat it again, strong heating. So this is what I got, a B as a product. Okay, this is what I'll be getting, a B as a product. Okay, So after heating, so I'll be getting a B as a product. So once I got this product, again I have to heat, so the ammonia is getting eliminated. So here NH2, here just I'm writing a trick. So here it is, I'll be getting a form, the product like this. This is what I'll be getting a product. That is a C double bond O NH and C double bond O NH. This is nothing but a thalidomide. So from the thalic acid, I'll be reacting with ammonia and heat. After that, I'll be getting some intermediate that will be heated. I'll be getting diamide. After that, that will be strongly heated. I'll be getting thalidomide as a product. Okay. Right. And next one is a text to distinguish phenol and benzoic. This is also very simple. So here, if I react with sodium bicarbonate, this will give brisk effervescence. Okay, this will give brisk effervescence. And with that, NaOH, there is no brisk effervescence. Okay, from that we can able to, because both are acidic, but in the case CO2, which is getting eliminated in this case only, that is what it is a good test to distinguish between phenol as well as benzoic acid. I think so you understand well. Thank you so much for watching. Please go forward to others to get benefit, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you once again. Thank you. Thank you for learning. Share and like this video.